So with that said, I want to thank you all for coming. This is a very important moment that we need to be doing. We like to do this regularly, 4 times a year, I think, is the goal. 5? Great, that's even better. And I'm going to be around. If you have any questions, I'd like to chat with you about the elementary schools, if you don't mind. And I'm going to turn this over to the mayor for closing comments.
Again, thank you all for coming. And thank you, Joe and Bates and Rebecca and staff and all the citizens here. It's been a distinct honor of mine to serve as your mayor for the last 2.5 years. As you might know, the first terms of anybody in a new city are always staggered or shortened from what they would be in regular city operations. So Joe's first term was a year, now he's got a 4-year term. Rebecca and myself and me and Bates, our terms expired this year. So in regards to what Joe's succession plan was talking about, anybody appointed to anything in the next month or so will have to stand for election in November so that you get your choice at the ballot box then as well. But yes, many of you know this, but I will be resigning next week as your mayor. This will be my last town hall as the mayor of Brookhaven. And I'll be running for another office vacated by State Representative Mike Jacobs. I think that my experience as mayor has been made so wonderful by the fact that, you know, I've held over 100 Mondays with the mayor. I'm gonna have another one Monday, and Mondays with the mayor, my last one, where I've gotten perspective. I meet 5 or 6 citizens, 7, 8, 9 sometimes on a Monday, and I get to hear from you directly, the citizens of Brookhaven, about issues you care about and things you want done, and they've been so beneficial. So I hope that tradition continues with whoever the next mayor is. I've also done dozens of walks with the mayor. I know there's some folks here who have participated in those with me. Those have been great for your elected official to go into your neighborhood on your terms so that you can walk around your neighborhood and point out the things that you want to see done or issues that you might have. So, you know, those things, the town halls, we have more town halls than any other city that, you know, when we go to these the municipal conventions, they always say, why do you have so many town halls? I couldn't handle that, that's ridiculous. It's what we were founded upon. But we started the city, didn't we, Rebecca and Lindley and everybody? We started the city through town hall meetings. That's how it worked, is you get together as a group, you hash out your differences, you argue, you praise, you criticize, and you give your ideas. So building community through town halls, through the festivals that we have, through the food trucks, through Mondays with the mayor, through walks with the mayor, through the Brookhaven 101, all these things, we do more than any other city in the metro area when it comes to engaging our citizens on specific issues. We always need to do more of that. We need to hear from you more emails, more phone calls. We get, you know, dozens and dozens of emails about all kinds of issues. We got plenty on the Oak Forest issue. We didn't get as many on the Asher Green this time that I thought we would, but it was evident when the folks came, there were some concerns about it as well. But again, I enjoyed being your mayor. This public service is what was fulfilling to me. We don't do it for the salary. You know, they make $12,000 a year and the mayor makes $16,000 a year. It's not about...
You make more than us.
It's not about that, but when the satisfaction I get from being the mayor of Brookhaven is when I see the tax dollars that were previously, in many instances, wasted, taken and applied to things that I know that the citizens of Brookhaven want, which is paving, which is police, which is a world-class police department, which is sidewalks, which is park improvements, stormwater, the 911, we have our own fire marshal. That is what motivates me and motivates all of us when we see the application of resources, your resources, to ideas. And many times they're your ideas. And that's what this city is all about. We've had our bumps in the road, but it's on balance. To have cut taxes twice, to have a $4 million reserve, and have the police department we have, the paving, and all the work that we've done, it's been a great win for the citizens of Brookhaven to have this city. And I think most people agree with that. They come up and tell me all the time, to grab me by the arm at the grocery store. I know you don't hear it enough, but I just want to thank you. Y'all are doing so many great things. And I tell them, you know what, I do hear it. So I appreciate you telling me that. So we have the best, most intelligent, educated citizens in the metro area. We have the best city council. We've got some of the best staff. And I just want to thank you, the citizens of Brookhaven, for making Brookhaven what it is. Keep staying engaged. Protect your neighborhoods. Protect your city. Ask for more. Make sure that you get your taxpayers' dollars worth. And I'll see you soon. I'm not going anywhere. I'm staying right here in Brookhaven. So thank you so much for coming. And thank you for being here.